The pneumatic system supplies bleed air to operate the air conditioning systems, wing and engine anti-ice systems, water system pressurization, hydraulic reservoir pressurization, and operate the engine starters. Compressed air is supplied to the pneumatic system by the engines, the APU.
So we're going to have the pneumatic system. Source. The pneumatic system is like the electrical. Remember the electrical? We have three sources to put electrical power on the airplane, right? His own generator, external power, or APU. The pneumatic system also has three sources. We can get pneumatic from the engine, from an APU, or from an external pneumatic car. Remember that we spoke about the for the cross bleed for the pneumatic car in case the APU is inoperative? So, now what do we use the pneumatic system for? Well, that's what we use it for, all these systems. So we can pressurize, or we can use it for the air conditioning, wing anti-ice, engine anti-ice, water pressurization, hydraulic reservoir, and for the starter. So we can start the engine, okay? So that's why we use pneumatic. If we don't have APU, like you say, then we have to get an external pneumatic car. Okay, then we start one engine, and then we do a cross bleed start. The cross bleed start is gonna be on the supplementary procedure book that I put on your flash drives. You have that there, okay? Got it? So that's what we use the pneumatics. So three ways to get pneumatics, okay? From the engines, APU, or an external pneumatic car. The panel for the pneumatic system right here.
The control panel for the pneumatic system.
Normally, from here down, from the pack and the isolation valve is pneumatic. From the pack and isolation valve up is air conditioning. Okay, but this is the panel for pneumatic and air conditioning. Okay, both things. And now we're gonna look at the diagram, how the diagram looks like.
The switches and lines drawn on the control panel appear similar to the actual schematic of the pneumatic system. Let's look at the diagram.
Let's look at the diagram. So if you look at the panels, remember I've been telling you this since yesterday. The panels, pretty much, if you follow the lines, represent the schematic. So if you learn the panels good, you can visualize pretty much the schematic. So you see you have two engine bleed valves. Remember, the engine bleed valves are electrically controlled by the switch, 28 volt DC. Pneumatically operated, you need pressure to open the valves. The normal position for the engine bleed valves are on. This is Boeing procedure. You never put those engine bleed switches off, unless if it's company procedure or an abnormal procedure, okay? Other than that, they always gonna be on. So what does that mean, guys? If the valve is electrically controlled by the switch, 28 volt, you already sending 28 volt to the valve to open when you have pressure. Make sense?
Yeah.
So because the switches are they always in the on position, you already sending 28 volt DC to the valve to open, automatically, as soon as you have pressure coming from the fifth or ninth stage that we're gonna see in a minute. Then you're gonna have in the middle the APU bleed valve. You have the engine bleed switches, APU bleed valve, right? And then you have the two pack switches and the isolation valve, three position switch. You got it? Mm-hmm. Okay, now let's look at the diagram, see how it goes. Here it is, exactly the same.
Okay. This is a simple view of the diagram. We'll add components as we go along. As an overview, you can see the system consists of left and right manifolds that are normally isolated by the closed isolation valve. As you can imagine,
because
the isolation valve can be opened to interconnect the left and right
manifolds.
More on that later.
Let me move it three slides, because now it's going to add a little bit more stuff here. Wait a minute. Now you have the APU.
The APU can supply bleed air to both manifolds when the aircraft is on the ground and a single manifold to 17,000 feet when in flight.
Now, if you see here, let me go to the next slide. Just put this little cabinet there. And then it's blocking my view. Right here. Okay.
An external air supply can provide compressed air to the right manifold when the aircraft is parked. The external air connection is located on the lower right side of the aircraft fuselage.
Okay. Now, You see over here, you have engine number one, engine number two, okay? Now you have the APU and the external pneumatic part. Look that the APU is connected to the left manifold. This is your right manifold. What is split, what divides the left manifold from the right manifold? The isolation valve. So you can see that the APU is connected to the left manifold. The external pneumatic air is connected to the right side of the manifold. You see that?
Yeah.
Good? Okay. Now, you're gonna have the engines here, engine number one. You have the fifth stage and the ninth stage. This is your engine bleed valve. That normally is electrically controlled by the engine bleed switches, electrically controlled, pneumatically operated by the fifth or ninth stage. Remember that the valves are 28 volt DC, okay? Controlled by the switch. So, how does this work? Normally, when you start the engine, because we already have the engine bleed switches on, you already sending 28 volt DC to the valve. Assume the fifth, the engine start, now you're gonna have pressure, right, from the fifth stage, and it's gonna open the engine bleed valve automatically, because you already send an electrical signal to open when you have pressure. If the fifth stage doesn't have enough pressure to open that valve, then automatically switch to the ninth stage. This is automatically, we don't have control of this. And then the ninth stage kicks in and open the engine bleed valve. Because the ninth stage is further aft at the engine, the pressure is much, much higher. But at the same time, the temperature is gonna be way, way higher. So what's gonna happen? Now you have a pre-cooler. The purpose of the pre-cooler is to maintain, this is a temperature sensor, around 200 degrees, okay? Right, to maintain that temperature at 200 degrees. Now, normally this is when it's coming from the fifth stage, but if it's coming from the ninth stage, now the pre-cooler says, oh man, I need some help because this temperature is too high for me. So automatically, it's gonna send a signal to the fan air valve to open, and then air from outside is gonna help the pre-cooler to maintain the proper temperature coming up. This is automatically, we don't have control of this. All this happens automatically. The only thing that we do have control is the engine bleed valve using the engine bleed switches. Okay? Good.